Right, okay. If you say that this is the case, then answer is says Anandagiri on page 18, etavan vai kamah iti sarvakarmanam avisheshena phalasambandha shravanat pashvadesha kamya phalatvasya tadviri uddesha vashat siddhatvat karmana pitruloka iti vakyasya nityadi karmaphala vishetvat na moksha phalatva ashanka iti parihati naiti. In short, the Siddhanti wants to make a point that even nitya and everyday karma also have a result. And the Shruti mentions that result in its own way. Even if you do not find directly the mention of the result in the vicinity of nitya and everyday karma, there is a discussion in the Purva Mimamsa. Apart from nitya and everyday karma, there are other rituals also for which the result is not specifically mentioned. Then what will you consider result to be? Then Mimamsa, Jaimini said, Swarga is the result. Of course, that Swarga you can call moksha, but Swarga was said to be the result of all those rituals of which the result is not mentioned. But here we will show how the Shruti Upanishad here itself mentions the result of all various rituals by lumping them together. And therefore, Nitya Namidhi Karma also have a result, namely Pitru Loka, etc. And therefore, they are not without result, and therefore you cannot say that their result is moksha. That's the point that we made.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamaiva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Atmedi Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Lakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om
17
Nanityanam Samsara Vishaya Phalatvam Iti Chet.
This question also being answered in course. Nanityanam samsara phala vishayatvam. This is the view of the Purupakshi, who says that nitya naimide karma should be considered as giving rise to moksha. This is what? Because they don't mention specifically the result of nitya naimitika karma. They do not mention specifically the means for attainment of moksha. Therefore, moksha is lacking the means, and nitya naimitika karmas are lacking the end. Therefore we say that we connect the two. Gujarati must lakade makadu vagad ho jaye. Also, you connect the two things, you know. Anyway, so you connect these nitya naimitika karmas with moksha, because they can become the means and this can become the end. The idea is there that after all Shruti says that you should perform the nitya naimitika, your daily and obligatory duties. There must be some reason. And if the reason or prayojanam of the purpose is not specifically mentioned, it must be for the evolution of the person. And therefore it is also reasonable to believe that since Shruti enjoins his actions, there must be a purpose, and a noble purpose also must be there. And therefore they say that the purpose of nitya naimitika karma must be moksha. So says on page 18, Anandagiri ukte sarva karmanam bandha phalatve nitya naimittikanam natatvatvam tesham vidhyuddeshe phala ashratehe nashtashva dagdarthanyayena mukti phalatva labhad iti shankate. Sarva karmanam bandha phalatve ukte, when it is said that all the karmas, you said, are only within the realm of bondage,
Nitya Naimittikanam na Tatphalatvam. The Nitya and Naimittika Karma are not within the realm of, meaning the result of Nitya Naimittika Karma is not within the realm of samsara. Tesham Vidhi Uddeshe Phala Ashrutehe. Vidhi Uddeshe Vidhayaka Vakya, meaning there is a Vakya for Nitya Naimittika Karma. And after that Vakya, meaning Aharaha Sandhyam Upasita. So one should perform Sandhya every day. Or Yavad Jivam Agnihotram Juhuya. That every, for the whole life one should perform Agnihotra Karma. So there is Vidhi there. So Vidhayaka Vakya is there, number one. At the same time, Phala Ashrutehe. And there is no Phala. So Vidhi shows that this Karma must be Ishta Sadhanam. When the Vedas enjoin us some action, that means it must be for our welfare. And there is no phala specifically mentioned, that means it is not kamya karma. It is not a desire prompted action, therefore it must give rise to result other than the desire prompted actions. And therefore they say it must give rise to result, namely moksha.
Nastashva dagdarasanyayana mukti phalatva labhat.
And therefore we say that is how you can say they are the means for moksha, therefore the nanityanam. Then the Siddhant is going to say here, Anandagiri continues, etavanvai kamaha idi etavanvai jaya putra vitta karmani eva kamaha kamaitavya vishayaha. In this very Upanishad, here the Shruti says, etavanvai, this much indeed, is kama, this much is kama. So what are the various desires that a person can entertain? Jaya putra vitta karmani. So these are the ends that a person can seek. Jaya, vitta and putra. Jaya means a wife, then putra means a son, and vitta means wealth. Idea is that even wife, son and wealth are also means for some karma. Wife is means when alone one is qualified to perform action. The Vedic action one can perform only when one is married. And therefore, that is how wife becomes jaya me syat atha karma kurviya. May I get married so that I can perform these rituals. There are some rituals which a brahmachari can perform and there are some which a vanaprastha can perform, but basically, what we call the rituals of karma is primarily performed by householder. Therefore, jaya is necessary in that sense, to perform this karma, so that he can attain the various ends of his life. Then vitta or the wealth also becomes necessary for accomplishment of any karma, because you require resources to perform the rituals. That is how vitta also becomes a means, and putra also becomes a means. Putra, if you have, then alone you can attain this world. The idea is that a person who is given all the pinda etc. alone will have a place in this world. So that is how putra, jaya and vitta, these become the means for fulfillment of various aims in life. And therefore you don't require anything more than this. The idea is this is it. As far as the fulfillment of various aims is concerned, they can be accomplished by these means. And therefore Upanishad concludes, etavan vai kamaha. This much indeed is kama. Kama means kamaitavya vishaya. That this much is a vishaya. This is what you can desire to accomplish various ends. So kamya karma or desire prompted actions have this much scope. As it will say that karmana ayam lokaha vidya devloka, no, putrena ayam lokaha karmana pitrulokaha vidya devlokaha. By putra you can attain this world. Meaning you can come back to this world if your son, who will do all the rites and everything. Then if you perform the Vedic rituals, then you can gain Pitruloka. And if you also perform meditations, then you can get Devaloka. So this is the achievement that a person can have within the realm of desires. And this is the means that the person requires in order to fulfill the ends. That's it. So this is the life of a person. As far as the fulfillment of various desires are concerned, the various desires can be included within what we call the desire for this world, desire for Pitruloka and desire for Devaloka. That includes अप टू ब्रह्मलोकम. सो देवलोक ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स डिजायर अप टू ब्रह्मलोकम. सो दैट इज द स्कोप ऑफ डिजायर दैट अ पर्सन कैन हैव. एंड फॉर फुलफिलमेंट ऑफ दिस डिजायर व्हाट डज अ पर्सन वांट? ही वांट्स जाया वित्त एंड पुत्र. सो दैट इज व्हाट ही वुड वांट, दैट आई शुड हैव दिस दिस एंड दिस सो दैट विद द हेल्प ऑफ देम आई कैन अटेन दैट दैट एंड दैट. सो अटेनमेंट ऑफ दिस थ्री वर्ल्ड्स इज व्हाट अ पर्सन कैन सीक. And for attainment, this is the means that a person requires. So that sums up the total scope of life of a person who wants to fulfill various desires. So the summing up all the desires and summing up all the desire ends. Upanishad says, etavan vai kamaha. This is the scope of the desires, or this is the scope of the desirable ends. Kamaitavya vishayah. The desire, the object that a person seeks or desires. So etavan vai kamahiti sarva karmanam avisheshana phala sambandha shravanat. So when you say etavan vai kama, this is the scope of all the ends and the means, then sarva karmanam avisheshana phala sambandha shravanat, which means that all possible actions which are prompted by desires can give rise to result within this scope of this world, Pitruloka and Swargaloka. Pashvadischa kamya phalatvasya tadvidhyuddeshavashat. All this Pashu and Putra and Kalatra and all this wealth and whatever one can seek, kamya phalatvasya. So kamya phalatvasya means kamya karma phalatvasya. That Pashu etc. can become Kamya Karma Phala. Pashu means cattle. So cattle is the phala or the result of Kamya Karma, desire prompted actions. So when you perform actions prompted by desire, then you can attain all this cattle and wealth and whatever else. Tad vidyuddesha vashat siddhatvat. So various karma, the ends are also mentioned with reference to various karma. Therefore, all the Pashu, etc., cattle and whatever, all of them are mentioned by the Vedas as the various ends to be acquired as a result of performance of various actions. Karmana pitruloka hai di vakyasya nityadi karma phala vishayatvat. The idea is that whatever Vedas mention as kamya karma or desire prompted actions, the result of all those actions is summed up as Pashu, etc. And where Vedas do not specifically mention the result, like Nitya Naimijaya Karma, then Karmana Pitruloka. By Karma one attains Pitruloka. By what Karma? We would imagine by Nitya Naimijaya Karma, because for rest of the Kamya Karma specific results are mentioned. And for this Karma specific results are not mentioned. Therefore we say Karmana Pitruloka. So this Pitruloka is by karma and Nitya Naimitika are karma, and therefore Karmana Pitruloka is the Vakyasya Nityadi Karma Vishaya Phalatvat, Karma Phala Vishayatvat, that it must be the result of Nitya Naimitika Karma. So Nityadi Karma Phala Vishayatvat, Nityadi Karma Phala Bodhakatvat. Your Nastashva Dagdarsan Nyaya should be applied here, that Pitruloka is by karma and the Nitya Naimitya Karma do not have specific result mentioned there. Therefore, Pitruloka must properly be the result of Nitya Naimitya Karma. The Moksha Phalatva Ashanka. Therefore, all karmas and various results are reconciled. It's like accountants, you know. Both the sides, all of them must be equalized. That's all. Somehow they manage it. The accounts people somehow manage to make both the sides equal by any way. And similarly here also, all karmas and karma phalas are properly accounted for. So no karma remains to be accounted for and no karma phala remains to be accounted for in the Vedas. Therefore we say that na moksha phalatva ashanka. You cannot imagine that this karma is the result in moksha, because this karma, nitya namidya karma, result in pitruloka, and therefore they are also properly balanced or reconciled. So with this, Mahashakara Pariharati answer, if refutes this, says naiti. Na sarva karma phalopa samhara shrutehe. Says Vashika, says na सर्व कर्म फल उपसंहार श्रुते है। सी फुट नंबर 5 देयर। सामान्येन सर्व कर्म फल संग्राहक श्रुतौ कर्म फलांतर्गतत्वेन मोक्षस्य अश्रवणाद् इत्यर्थः। सामान्येन सर्व कर्म फल संग्राहक श्रुतौ, देयर आर स्पेसिफिक रिजल्ट्स फॉर स्पेसिफिक एक्शंस, देन देयर आर जनरल रिजल्ट्स। सामान्य कर्म फल संग्राहक श्रुतौ, कर्मणा पितृलोकः, विद्या देवलोकः। सो दिस इज श्रुति। विद्या मीन्स मेडिटेशन, दिस इज अ विच पर्टिकुलर मेडिटेशन, अ विच पर्टिकुलर कर्म। एंड देयर सामान्येन इन जनरल सर्व कर्म फल संग्राहक श्रुतौ, दिस श्रुति स्टेटमेंट्स आर सर्व कर्म फल संग्राहक, दे आर ऑल इंक्लूसिव फॉर वेरियस एक्शंस इन जनरल। सो दे मेंशन द रिजल्ट्स ऑफ एक्शंस इन जनरल। एंडेवर कर्म फलांतर्गतत्वेन, एंडेवर इवन द नित्य नैमित्तिक कर्मास आर ऑल्सो इंक्लूडेड, एज दे ऑल्सो आर इंक्लूडेड इन द सामान्य कर्म फल श्रुति। सो मोक्षस्य अश्रवणात्, वी डू नॉट फाइंड श्रुति सेइंग दैट नित्य नैमित्तिक कर्म गिव्स अस टू मोक्ष, वी डोंट सी दैट। ऑफ कोर्स यू डोंट सी द स्पेसिफिक रिजल्ट मेंशन फॉर नित्य नैमित्तिक, but you do find other shruti statements which sum up the results of all the actions in general, like karmana pitruloka, vidya devaloka, etc. Therefore it is only reasonable to say that the nitya nirmiti karma also are included in those general statements, and there is no mention of moksha as the result of the karma phala, and then moksha is not a karma phala also. Therefore we say that nitya nirmiti karma do not give rise to moksha, they also give rise to only result within the realm of samsara. Uktameva sphutayati, what is said here, Bhashyakara explains it clearly. Sarvam hi patni sambandham karma jaya mesyat एतावान् वै कामः इति निसर्गतः एव सर्वकर्मणां काम्यत्वं दर्शयित्वा पुत्र कर्म अपरविद्यानां च अयं लोकः पितृलोकः देवलोकः इति फलं दर्शयित्वा त्र्यन्नात्मकतां च अन्ते उपसंहरिष्यते। त्रयं वा इदं नाम रूपं कर्म इति सर्वकर्मणां फलं व्याकृतं संसार एवेति। सर्व ही पत्नी संबद्धम कर्म, सर्व ही कर्म, ऑल द कर्म इज पत्नी संबद्धम, सो ऑल द कर्म इज कनेक्टेड और एसोसिएटेड विद पत्नी, मीनिंग देन अलोन यू कैन परफॉर्म दिस कर्म विच इज लर्न्ड बाय व्हाट, जाया में स्यात्, दैट्स व्हाई दिस पर्सन हैज अ डिजायर, जाया में स्यात् अतः कर्म कुर्वीय, मे हैव अ वाइफ, मे बी मे गेट मैरिड सो दैट आई कैन परफॉर्म दिस रिचुअल्स, बिकॉज ही इज इंटरेस्टेड इन द रिजल्ट्स that those rituals give. But he could not perform those rituals unless he is qualified to perform them. And who is qualified? Only a married person is qualified to perform the rituals. So if you have interest in the result that those rituals give, then you must gain the qualifications to perform those rituals. If you are not interested in those results, then you need not gain that qualification. So even at the time of Brahmacharya, if a person has recognized somehow the limitations of all those result ends, then there is no need that the person has to enter the grihastha ashrama, because according to this tradition, entering grihastha ashrama is primarily the reason for performing karma, vaidika karma, so that person can fulfill various desires. It is accepted that a person has desires, different kama or desires are there, and therefore to fulfill those desires, the person requires a certain setup. And therefore, that setup must be there. Otherwise, it will be illegitimate to fulfill those desires. So, to fulfill the desires by legitimate means, you must create a legitimate setup. And that's how the person should get married, if the person wants to fulfill various kinds of desires. Thus, jaya me syad, that shows that sarvam hi patni sambandham karma, that karma is connected or associated with patni, wife. Etavan vai kamah, this much is the scope of kama or the desires or the desired ends. Iti nisargata eva, iti vakyena. So by this kind of statements, nisargata eva sarvakarmanam kamyattam darshayitva. Shruti shows sarvakarmanam nisargata kamyattam. All the karmas are prompted by desires only. So this will be, there will be elaborate discussion when we come to that. And in such Upanishad Aitareya, or I think Mundaka also, while mentioning, or Keno Upanishad, while mentioning these statements, Bhashyakara showed how all these actions are only prompted by desires. So nisargata eva sarvakarmanam kamyatvam darshayitva. Shruti shows how naturally all these actions are prompted by desires. Kamyat means kamyaman phalasadhanatvam. That all the actions become actually means for fulfillment of some desired ends. Then specifically, putra karma aparavidyanam cha, having said the results of all actions in general, coming to particular means putra karma aparavidya. Aparavidya means meditation. That putra karma and meditation, ayam lokaha, putra gives rise to ayam lokaha, karma gives rise to pitru lokaha, aparavidya meaning meditation gives rise to deva lokaha iti phalam darshayitva. Then trinyatmakatam chante upasamharishyati. And also at the end, trinyatmakatam, footnote number 3, purvokta saptannanam namaditraye sankshepakaranat aha trinyati. Triyannam. So there is a saptanna section there which talks about 7 kinds of food which will come when we discuss that when a person performs an action, he creates 7 kinds of food for devatas, for human beings, and for pashus, and for everyone in general. So the 7 kinds of food are created when you perform action. That is how the whole samsara is created. But those 7 kinds of food are again summarized into 3 kinds of food. Nama, rupa, and karma. Meaning when a person performs an action, then those actions become the means for the creation of nama, rupa, and karma. Name, form, and activity. That is what the whole creation consists of. So at one point the whole creation was looked upon as consisting of 7 kinds of food. For the pashu, there is this, the food was there for the human beings, and for the devatas, and general 7 kinds of food are there. So you look upon the samsara that way, or idam nama rupam karma. Name, form, and karma are the, you can summarize again those 7 kinds, you know, name, form, and karma, which includes the whole samsara. And thus it is said that the scope of all the karmas is to give rise a result within this realm of name, form, and kriya, meaning within the realm of samsara. Says patni sambandhe manamaha jayame shadhi. Then Anandagiri says, tathapi katham karmanah sarvasya kamapayatvam. How do you say that karmanah sarvasya kamapayatvam? Footnote number 16, kamapayatvam, kamyaman phalasadhanatvam. How do you say that all the actions are necessarily means for attainment of desired ends? So, etavan vai kama, as we explained, this much is the kama and this much is the desired ends that one can seek. Katham tarhi tesham phalabhedah labhyate. If you say that all the karmas are means for attainment of the different ends, then how do you distinguish different karma as means for different kinds of ends? Then Vashyakara said, putra karma aparavidyanam ayam lokah pitralokah devalokah. Putra gives rise to ayam lokah, karma gives rise to pitralokah, aparavidya gives rise to devalokah. Atha evam phalavihage katham samasti vyasti prapti phalatvam ashvamedhasya uktamidi. Says footnote number 18, Atha evam phala vibhage, atha nanau, atha means nanu, eva means tridha. Nanu एवं त्रिधा फल विभागे व्हेन दिस यू हैव क्लासिफाइड ऑल द रिजल्ट्स इन दिस थ्री नाम कर्म एंड क्रिया और रादर अयम लोक है पितृलोक है एंड देवलोक है दिस इज द वे यू डिवाइड ऑल द कर्मस कथम समष्टि व्यष्टि प्राप्त फलत्वम देन हाउ कैन अश्वमेधस्य उक्तम How is it said that Ashwamedha ritual gives rise to the result of the nature of samasti vyasti prapti, Hiranyakarma? Ityaha trinyatmakadam chande upasamharishyati. That ultimately Hiranyakarma also is included within the scope of nama, rupa and karma. Asya dhyayasya avasane karmaphalasya Hiranyakarma rupadam tremityadhyasati upasamharishyati ityartha. At the end of this chapter and the sixth brahmana of this chapter, कर्मफलस्य हिरण्यगर्भ रूपदाम दैट कर्मफल अल्टीमेटली गिव्स राइज़ टू हिरण्यगर्भ त्रयम् इत्याद्या श्रुतिः दिस त्रयम् वायदम् नाम रूपम् कर्म दिस श्रुति उपसंहरिष्यति इट कंक्लूड्स बोधयिष्यति इट शोज हाउ ऑल द कर्मास अल्टीमेटली गिव राइज़ टू कर्म आई मीन रिजल्ट विद इन द रियलम ऑफ नाम रूप एंड कर्म एंड दैट इज द हिरण्यगर्भ उपसंहार श्रुतेः तात्पर्यमः सर्वकर्मणामिति नेवर सर्वकर्मणाम फलम व्याकृतम व्याकृतम फुटनोट नंबर 6 नाम रूपात्मना अभिव्यक्तम सर्वकर्मणाम फलम व्याकृतम दैट ऑल द कर्मास गिव राइज टू फल व्हिच इज मैनिफेस्ट एज नाम रूपात्मना अभिव्यक्तम कर्मा गिव राइज टू रिजल्ट व्हिच आर ओनली ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ नाम रूप एंड कर्म देयर इज नो कर्म व्हिच नेयर कर्म मींस एक्टिविटी There is no karma or the action which can give rise to result beyond the scope of name, form and activity. Even Hiranyagarbha also is included within this category of name, form and activity. The Hiranyagarbha is a name, Hiranyagarbha is a form and Hiranyagarbha is a function. So name, form and function. Anything and everything that is in the creation can be said to have these three. Name, form and function including Hiranyagarbha. Right of Pipilika also is a name, form and function. And therefore, that is the scope of the result that any and every karma can result into. So, sarva karmanam phalam vyakritam. The result of all the actions is manifest. Manifest is nama rupatmana abhivaktam tathacha karyameya vastu karma phalam. The idea is that karma phalam, or result of an action is karyam, is something that is a product. Something that is created. Na siddha rupam. Karma must necessarily give rise to result which is not presently there. Even nitya naimitika karma also. Even all action of worship, whenever action is involved, it must produce some apurva. It must produce some effect which is not presently there. Even acts of worship also create apurva. Create antahakana shuddhi. So samskar karya. Samskaranam, removal of impurity from our mind is called samskaranam. And so it is that samskar karya that nitya naimitya karmas also accomplish. So action must necessarily accomplish a result which is not presently there. And moksha is siddha. Moksha means atma is already mukta. And therefore moksha cannot be the result of any action because any action which is performed with this kartrutva buddhi, that I am performing an action, whether it is performed with the expectation of a result or not. Even nishkama karma should also produce a result. Sakama karma or the action performed with the desire must necessarily produce a result. But even when you perform an action without the desire, then also it should produce a result. Because if the action is being performed, the cause is there, therefore the effect must be created. So what result will it produce? When you do not desire anything, what result will it produce? It will produce a result of purification. Since you do not desire a particular end, therefore that action will go in eliminating some of the obstacles, eliminating some of the impurities from your mind. But that also is a result. Na siddha rupam, karma cannot give rise to a result which is already there, you know, because then it cannot be karma. So, moksha being siddha cannot be karmaphala. Karmaphala always has to be of the nature of nama, rupa and karma, name, form and function. So thus it is said that Even Nitya, Naimitika karma also should be included within the realm of those which have result within the realm of samsara. That's all. Then Anandagiri continues, karma phalam samsarascet praktad anusthanat tad abhavat muktanam punarbandhasyad iti ashankyah. Karma phalam samsarascet, if result of the action is samsara, meaning within the realm of samsara, praktat anusthanat, footnote number 20, tat anusthanat, karma anusthanat prak, meaning before the performance of karma, tat abhavat, karma abhavat, naturally, if you say that karma gives rise to the result of the nature of samsara, then what about the state when karma is not performed? This thing, the question always arises, how about the beginning before the karma started? It is karma action that results into samsara. But how about a state before the action? Before action started, there was a state that is called pragabhava of karma, meaning the prior non-existence of karma. That means that before karma there should be no samsara. Or if samsara is anadi, then samsara can be there even if karma is not there. So if karma gives rise to samsara, if someone stops performing karma, then also there should be samsara. So if that is the idea then. So praktat anusthanat tad abhavat muktanam punah bandhasyat. See footnote number 22, muktanam punar bandhayati yatha prak karma abhavevi prathamika samsara agamaha. So how did the samsara come in the beginning? Why did he perform karma to begin with? Who will perform karma? You said that karma or action is always performed by some desire. That means karma shows the existence of desire. And what does desire indicate? Desire indicates a sense of inadequacy. What does the sense of inadequacy indicate? It indicates ignorance or samsara. So karma is a product of ignorance. That means ignorance must be there before karma. That means samsara is there before karma also. Otherwise karma could not have been originated to begin with. If samsara is not there, why should karma be there? Why should I perform any action? If I am fine, if I am happy, if I am complete, there is no need to perform action. The very need to perform action arose because I felt a sense of incompleteness. That means I was a samsari even before performance of karma. That means samsara can exist even independent of karma. So yatha prak karma abhavevi prathamika samsara agamaha. Somehow the samsara came even before the performance of karma. If you say that the karma and the result of the karma is within the scope of samsara, we say that the samsara was there even before performance of karma, and therefore tathaiva jnanangidagdha karmana muktanami punaragamasya vinayava karma bhityartha. And so also, let us say there is a wise man, you say that jnanangidagdha karmanam tamahuh panditam buddha, wise man is the one. All those karmas are destroyed or burned by the fire of knowledge. Means the wise man does not perform any actions anymore. But still, now a wise man is in a state which existed before the karma. That before karma also nobody perform action. And after wisdom also the wise man does not perform the action. And therefore the state in which the wise man is similar to the state that existed before the performance of karma. If there was samsara before the performance of karma, there can be samsara for wise men also, because samsara being what it is, it seems to be there when karma is not there also. So muktanam punah bandhasya, they are all arguments, standard arguments. So very briefly they are all mentioned. Iti ashankyaha, so one would suspect that even wise men also be stuck with samsara, because samsara is not a karma phala. Karma phala is within the realm of samsara. But samsara is independent, it seems. It was there even before karma, and therefore it can be there even after the wisdom. Idamayavaiti, Vashyakara says, Idamayavatrayam Pragutpattehe Tarhi अव्याकृतमासीत्। इदमेव त्रयम्, दिस नाम रूपम कर्म, दैट मीन्स दिस होल संसार, व्हाट इज संसार, नाम रूप एंड कर्म इज संसार। व्हेन नाम रूप कर्म इज देयर देन संसार इज देयर। देयर इदमेव त्रयम्, दिस होल संसार कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ द नेम फॉर्म एंड फंक्शन। उत्पत्ति है प्राग, बिफोर इट्स क्रिएशन, डोंट थिंक दैट इट इज वाज नॉन एग्जिस्टेंट। If this samsara was non-existent before its creation, then you will say that samsara was non-existent before its creation. Then you have to explain a state which existed before samsara. We say that there was no state before samsara, samsara was always there. If samsara was created afresh, then we have to explain what existed before samsara. But samsara always existed. Either in Vyakrata or manifest form, or of Vyakrata, undifferentiated, unmanifest form. But samsara was always there. Therefore, it is not that samsara was not there. This is the idea here. Therefore, Bhashyakara here also deals with the various sections that are going to come in this chapter. So, all these topics are going to be covered in this chapter also, the purport of which is given right here, in order to give us an overview of what to expect in this chapter. Apart from karma, these other topics are, apart from moksha, brahma vidya, these other topics are also discussed. So, idam eva trayam pragutpattehe tarhi avyakratam asid. Tarhi, footnote 7, avyakratam asid, anabhivyakta nama rupatmana sthitam asid ityartha, meaning, this whole creation consisting of name, form and function, existed as in an undifferentiated state. Tarhi anadigrishas tasyam avasthayam iti yavat. Before creation, it was as unmanifest or undifferentiated. Tasya punaha vyakarane karanamaha. If the creation was undifferentiated, unmanifest, then what was the need for it to get differentiated or manifest? So, there was some cause. Tasya punaha व्याकरणे कारणमाह, what is it? Footnote remains. Footnote number 7 we read. Oh, okay. सव्याकृतमासीत् अनविव्यक्तनाम रूपात्मना स्थितमासीत् इत्यर्थः तथा च न कस्यापि संसारस्य प्राथमिकत्वं वक्तुं शक्यते. Yes. So it is said, तथापि न कस्यापि संसारस्य प्राथमिकत्वं वक्तुं शक्यते. Then you cannot say that anybody's samsara has any beginning. Samsara for anybody has no beginning at all. Samsara is beginningless. Vidyotpatte prak tasya sarvada eva sattva. That means, before the dawn of knowledge, samsara was always there. There never was a state before karma. Karma was always there. Samsara was always there and karma was always there. That is how we say that samsara is beginningless. If it is a beginning, if God created the world, then the first day, second day and third day, then something existed before that creation. What was it? Enlightenment, knowledge, lack of samsara. Then why should samsara be created? Then there will be problem. Then God created samsara just to throw us into this kind of difficulty or what? So moment you try to give explanation for creation of samsara, a lot of difficulties are there. Even if God created this, why did He create? We say He is not created. That's all it amounts to. We would say that samsara really is not created. It has always been there. As mithya, it has always been there. As paramarthika, it is never there. As mithya, it is ever there. And therefore, it is not created in effect. That's why we call it beginningless. Therefore, there is no need to explain the reason for samsara. It has always been there. Why is it like this? Karma. Why is it there? It is always there. So, there is no explanation of samsara. Why is the world created? We have no explanation. Who created the world? Nobody created it. You can say, who made it manifest? God made it manifest. So, world also is part of God anyway. But it has not been created in that sense. It is created in the beginning of a given cycle of creation, alright. Means it is made manifest. What was in a state of unmanifestation is just made manifest, that's all. Tathā janakasyābhi samsārasya prāthamikatvam vaktum shakyare. विद्योत्पत्ते प्राक तस्य सर्वदा एव सत्वात् तस्य संसारस्य सर्वदा एव सत्वात् बिफोर द विद्या डाउन ऑफ नॉलेज संसार वाज ऑलवेज देयर इयामस्तु विशेष ऑल्दो दिस इज अ विशेष और दिस इज अ डिफरेंस आफ्टर द डाउन ऑफ नॉलेज and before dawn of knowledge or after creation and before creation this is vishesha yet kadachit vyaktataya kadachit cha avyaktataya iti this is vishesha that sometimes the samsara is in a manifest form and sometimes the samsara is in an unmanifest state that's the only difference in a manifest state or unmanifest state that's the only difference but samsara is ever there in one or the other state सो न कस्यापि संसारस्य प्राथमिकत्वं वक्तुं शक्यते इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू टॉक अबाउट प्राथमिकत्वं और बिगिनिंग ऑफ संसार ऑलराइट तस्य पुनः व्याकरणे कारणमाह सो व्हाट इज द कॉज फॉर व्याकरणम और डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ संसार इफ संसार वाज इन अ स्टेट ऑफ अनमैनिफेस्ट और स्टेट ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन देन व्हाट ब्रॉट अबाउट द डिफरेंशिएशन व्याकरणम Then Vashyakara says, Tadeva iti, says here, Tadeva punaha sarva prani karma vashat vyakriyate bijat iva vrukshah Tadeva punaha, the very same samsara that existed in avyakrita or undifferentiated state, the very same samsara in an undifferentiated state, Tadeva punaha sarva prani karma vashat, on account of karma, whatever it is that makes us wake up in the morning, apart from alarm, that is also our karma of course, but then, so without the alarm clock also, the person wakes up anyway, when the sleep is over. So whatever it is that wakes me up, is all the daily thing that I have to do during the day, and so all the karma that I perform until yesterday, they wake me up. Because they want to now, they become active. So now come on, we also want to play our role. In deep sleep, karma cannot play its role. You can't do anything, nor can you enjoy anything. There are desires to enjoy things, there are desires to do things. All those desires ultimately force this fellow to wake up. And similarly also, there was a grand sleep, grand universal sleep was there, which is what we call pralaya, the sleep of God. And what wakes up God also? Is all those sarva prani karma vashad. It is the sum total of the actions or desires of all the living beings, which manifests itself as the first desire. So kamayata, he desired. This desire has within itself the potential of all the desires of all the beings of all the time. All the desires of all the times of all the beings of all the time to come, of all the beings that there are, and all the desires, all of them are contained in a potential state, in that first desire of Lord, so kamayata, he desired. And it is this desires of the human beings, and all the living beings, which actually give shape to the universe, because we require a certain setup in order to gain the experiences, we require a certain setup in order to perform actions. So this also is a setup. This body that we have, the mind, intellect, you know, all of these are set up in order for us to perform various actions and experience the various results. The world also is a set up, world of objects also is a set up to give us the various experiences. So this setup has to be created in order to fulfill the desires. So world is nothing but a stage or a setup created in order to perform the actions, in order to fulfill the desire for experience, gain various experiences. Never, tadeva punaha sarva prani karma vashat vyakriyate bijadiva vrukshah. Just as a tree comes from a seed, meaning that the tree was present as a seed form, except that in the seed, that differentiation of all the various limbs or various components of the tree are not evident. Particularly when you take a little seed like the banyan tree, you don't see a banyan tree there. Perhaps some microscope might reveal that, but otherwise you don't see it. It is an undifferentiated tree. You can't differentiate this is a stem and this is a branch and this is a leaf, etc. And all of that just becomes differentiated. That's all happens. and not that a new tree is created. This is the idea. Suppose somebody discovers something else about the seed and tree, then we will give up this illustration. That's all it is. The idea is that what is unmanifest alone becomes manifest, and what is undifferentiated becomes differentiated. If you don't have an illustration, well, that's your problem, but this is what it is. Anyway, seed, bijang, so bijasyang tarivang karo jagadidam, that is, the seed is and the sprout illustration is there, and has to be there. This is satkaryavada. That effect cannot come out from blue. Something cannot be created from nothing. There must be a cause for any effect. This is why we accept the cause-effect chain, and nothing can happen by accident. You sow the mango seeds and something else will come. That cannot be. That is not found to be the case. We find a certain order existing in the universe that requires the relationship of cause and effect, and that therefore the seed is the cause and the sprout is the effect. Therefore, confident it can be said, bijadiva vrukshaha, just as a vruksha in a differentiated form arises from the seed, so also the samsara. Sri Ranandagiri, vyakrita avyakritatmanah samsarasya pramanikatvena satyatvam ashankya avidyakritatvena tan mithyatvam uktam smarayati. When you talk too much about samsara, then people say, oh, samsara is there, so it is satya. When we spend a lot of time explaining samsara, then people have other confusion. Oh, then samsara is real. It is not real. In spite of this much discussion, samsara is not real. Vyakrita avyakrita atmanah samsarasya, or the samsara which is of the nature of vyakrita or avyakrita. Pramanikatvena, footnote number 13, Shruti bodhyatvat. The Shruti also talks about samsara. So whatever Shruti says must be real, must be true. When Shruti also describes samsara, that means samsara is real. Iti asana satyatvam asankya avidyakritatvena tan mithyatvam uktam smarayati. Shruti does talk about samsara, but what is the cause of samsara that the Shruti gives? It gives the causes avidya. Avidyakritatvena, since samsara is a product of avidya, therefore mithyatvam tasya mithyatvam uktam smarayati. So footnote number 14 and page 14 actually also. On the page 14, then the paragraph, first paragraph, evam brahmadya sthavaranta swabhavika avidyaya doshavadah dharma dharma sadhana krita samsara gatihi nam rupa karmashraya. So samsara gatihi nam rupa karmashraya, this was already said. Svabhavika avidya doshavataha. For the person who is endowed with dosha of avidya, which is svabhavika, which is uncreated, and therefore that is the cause of samsara, is avidya, was already stated in the page 14, smarayati. That is just brought to again our memory. Soyam iti, Subhashyakara says, Soyam vyakrita vyakrita rupah samsarah avidya vishayah kriyakaraka phalatmakataya atma rupatvena adhyaropitah avidyaya eva murta murta tadvasanatmakah atah vilakshanah anamarupa karmatmakah advayah nitya shuddha buddha mukta svabhavopi kriyakaraka phala bhedadi viparyayena avabhasate. Soyam vyakrita avyakrita rupah samsarah. The samsara which is either manifest or unmanifest, which is there in one or the other state, avidya vishayah avidyakritah, is a product of ignorance. Kriyakarga phalatmakataya atmarupatvena adhyaropitah. क्रियाकारक फलात्मकतया सिस फुटनोट नंबर टू देर ऑन द पेज 19 निष्क्रिय अद्वय सिद्ध स्वरूप आत्मनि वेरी ब्यूटीफुल फुटनोट हियर निष्क्रिय अद्वय सिद्ध स्वरूप आत्मनि भासमानस्य संसारस्य अध्यारोपितत्व हेतुमाह इन फैक्ट द ट्रूथ इज आत्मा व्हाट इज द नेचर ऑफ आत्मा निष्क्रिय एक्शनलेस अद्वय इज नॉन ड्यूअल Siddha already existing, meaning ever accomplished. Self existing. Siddha means self existing. Samsara is actionless, non-dual, and self existing. Atmani or Atma suggests this. Bhasamanasya samsarasya. Samsara which is totally contradictory to this Atma, nevertheless shines upon this Atma. Hetumaha, that is why a samsara is called aropa, superimposition. So what is the hetu for the superimposition of samsara, which is totally contrary to the atma? Yushmat asmat pratyay go, yushmat pratyay samsara, asmat pratyay is atma. Tamah prakashvat viruddha svabhavayoho, both of them are totally contradictory. Then how is it possible for samsara, which is totally opposed to atma, to shine? Darpana drishyamana nagari tulyam. Darpana is what? Plain. Nischidram, Shuddha. On that the samsara, the chanagri that is seen is what? Having depth and multiplicity and all impurities, etc. How is it possible? So, avarupitatve hetumaha kriyakaraka phalatmakataya atmarupatvena adhyarupitha. Says the footnote, samsarohi kvachit kriyarupaha. Generally, often you find samsara kriya rupa, have the nature of activity. So where kriya or action is there, you can say that this is samsara. Satya nishkriye atmani vastutaha na sambhavati virodhat. And samsara which of the nature of kriya or activity, it is not possible for the samsara of the nature of activity to exist upon atma who is totally actionless. Virodha, therefore we say it is adhyaropa. Paraspara viruddha svabhavayoho. So viruddha svabhavayoho, therefore this anyonya, what is it? Viruddha svabhavayoho, itaretara bhava anupattau siddhayam. Itaretara bhava anupatti is not logical. It is not, if logically samsara can be explained then it becomes real. Anything that can be explained is real. If samsara can be explained, why it is there? And many, all other people explain samsara. This khyati, they give reason. Only Vedantin says anirvachaniya. Everybody gives reason for this khyati. That means according to them, samsara can be explained. And what can be explained or defined is real. Therefore, nayayikas give all the definitions. Because they say, take them to be real. Well, the definitions have certain reality as far as the vyavahara is concerned. But as far as Paramahata is, Paramahatik Satya is concerned, you cannot define any of these things. And so, Virodhat, since samsara of the nature of activity cannot possibly exist upon Atma with the nature of actionlessness, kvachitcha karakarupaha. Sometimes you can say samsara is, depends on how you define samsara. Sometimes you can define samsara as all activity. Sometimes you can define samsara as various karaka. Karta, karma, karana, etc. So all of these can be defined as samsara, called samsara. Tasya cha sadvayasya. Not sadvyasya, but sadvayasya advaya virodhad. This kriya, karaka, phala, all of these accessories are in the realm of duality. And this samsara of the nature of duality cannot possibly exist upon atma who is a non-dual. So there also virodha is there. Kvachicca phalatmakaha. Sometimes samsara can be defined as karma phala. Sometimes samsara can be defined as karma. Sometimes samsara can be defined as karaka. Sometimes samsara can be defined as karma phala also. Because karma itself is of somebody's karma phala. And karma phala becomes karma for something. So, kvachitcha phalatmakaha phalascheche karya rupataya siddhe vastuni vastutva virodhat adhyavirevaiti samsaraha sati samsarahiti. So, kvachit, phalasya kari rupadaya. Phalam is the result is that which is accomplished. Siddhe vastuni vastutva virodhat. Therefore, Atma is Siddha Vastu. He is not a product or self-existing. Therefore, it cannot be Karmaphala. So, samsara of the nature of Karmaphala is opposed to Atma, who is Siddha Vastu, and therefore, there is Virodha. So, three kinds of Virodha. Atma is Nishkriya, samsara is Sakriya. Atma is Advaya, samsara is Dvaita. Atma is Siddha and samsara is Sadhya. That's why Anandagiri, in explaining Karmanya Karmayav Pashet, Karmanya Karmayav Pashet, the word karma was explained as Dvaita also. Karma was explained as action and karma also was explained as duality. Akarma was explained actionlessness, akarma was explained as non-duality also. Because it is the opposite which is superimposed upon the opposite. That's the idea. So, Vashya says, Soyam vyakrata vyakrata rupaha samsaraha avidya vishayaha kriyakaraka phalatmakataya. So, that is kriyakaraka phalatmakatvam is the nature of samsara. Atma-rupatvena adhyaropitaha. Footnote number 3. Atma-rupatvena, atma-tadātmena. Adhyaropitaha, footnote number 4. Avidyaka-tadātma-sambandhena-idhyāvat adhyaropitaha adhyastaha. This samsara, which is totally contradictory to Atma, is nevertheless superimposed upon the Atma in such a manner that there is a total oneness between Atma and samsara. So, tadātmena-adhyastaha. Tadātmena, avidyaka tadātma sambandhena. There is a sambandha now between Atma and samsara, which is avidyaka, created by avidya. But sambandha is what? There is Atma bhava in the samsara. There is body, etc., which is samsara actually, are called Atma. Therefore, there is superimposition of the selfhood upon the samsara, which superimposition is created by avidya. And similarly also, the samsara dharma superimposed upon the Atma. Thus, there is a tadātma, like the taptāyaf pindavat, like the iron and the fire, how they become one with each other, so also the ātma and anātma, as though they become one with each other on account of ignorance. Without having really become one, they appear to be one with each other on account of ignorance. That's why it is called adhyāropa, adhyastaha. Avidyaya eva mūrta mūrta tadvāsanātmaka. So, avidyaya eva adhyastaha. Avidya eva arobitaha. It is superimposed by ignorance. So on account of ignorance alone, you can say that this avidyaka sambandha or avidyaka tadatme is created. The tadatme is created only on account of avidya. Again, murta murta tadvasanatmaka. That's another way of expressing samsara. Murta, again, having form. Amurta, having, which is formless. So murta is, which is manifest. Amurta is unmanifest. Gross and subtle. Tad vasanātmaka. And the various vasanas, the seeds, the samskaras, this murta and amurta. So gross, subtle and causal. So vasana is cause. However, you can say samsara is the nature of gross, subtle and causal world or kriya, karaka, phalātmaka. Either way you can say this samsara has been superimposed upon Atma, who is quite contrary to it by ignorance. So that's a footnote of 5, sthula sukshma tat samskaratmaka hai, sthula sukshma karanatmaka hai. Then ataha vilakshana hai, anam rupa karmatmaka hai, advaya hai. Now let us see if Anandagiri has to say. Says Anandagiri in the second line, Sae Shahi or Sae Vahi, that is a reading elsewhere in the Mahesh research, that looks like better. Sae Vahi, Bhranti Vishayaha, Na Pramanikaha. This samsara is Bhranti Vishayaha. Bhranti Vishayaha, Bhranti Prayukta, is created by Bhranti, Na Pramanikaha, is not really Pramanika. So even though Shruti talks about samsara, in the Shruti or Upanishad also, we have what we call Srishti Shruti. All description of creation, etc., we find in the Upanishad. Still, that is not for giving reality to creation, but to mention that this creation is nothing but Brahma. Sarvam khalu idam Brahma. The whole universe is nothing other than Brahman. If you see it as other than Brahman, then that is Bhranti. So all this Nama Rupa Karma is nothing but the Bhranti. So Brahman alone appears as Nama Rupa Karma. To say this is the purpose of the Srishti Shruti. So just because the samsara or the creation is found to be described in Upanishad, doesn't mean that it is real. The intention of the Upanishad is to show the mithyatvam of samsara and then to show the reality of Brahma. Na pramanikah tat kutah asya satyada tasmat kutah asya satyada. Then how can you say that the samsara is satya? Then Anandagiri continues, katham asya atmani advaye kutasthe praptihi. Katham asya bhranti mulaka samsarasya. If you say this samsara is caused by bhranti, it is a product of bhranti, bhranti hi mulam asya, it is bhranti mulaka. Atmani advaye kutasthe praptihi. Praptim sambandha. How is it possible that the samsara such as this can have any kind of relationship or anything to have to do with Atma, who is Advitiya and Kutastha, changeless and non-dual? How can there be relationship between these two? Gujarati, Miya Mahadev, you know. You cannot imagine relation between these two. Similarly also, this Mahadev and Death, you cannot imagine the relationship. Similarly also, this Samsara and Atma, you cannot imagine relationship. So how does it happen? Iti asankyaha kriya karaka phaladmakataya Atmarupatvena adhyarupitaha samarope moolakaranamaha avidyaya. So avidya is the moolakaranam, and then this namarupa kriyakaraka is the tula or the manifest samsara. Atmane avidyarupitam dvaitamityatra dvevava brahmanarupe murtam chaiva murtam chaityadi vakyam pramanayati. That this creation is superimposed upon the Atma on account of ignorance, that also is supported by the statement of the Shruti, Dvevava Brahmana Rupe. Again, the same Upanishad will be said, Brahma has these two manifestations, Murtam cha Amurtam cha. Dvavimam Purushav Loke, Kshara cha Akshara Eva cha. Kshara Sarvani Bhutani, Kutastho Akshara Uchade. Kshara here is this Murtam, and Akshara is Amurtam. So effect and cause are gross and subtle. So this whole creation consisting of gross and subtle is nothing but samsara. That's why Bhashyaka said, Murta Murta Tadvasanatmaka. Then Anandagiri continues, Nanu Atmani Aropaha Na Upapadyate. Is not tenable or logical that there is superimposition of samsara upon the Atma. Tasya Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Svabhavasya Dvaita Vilakshanatvat Asati Sadrushye Adhyasa Asiddhehe Atah Aha. So one of the important conditions for adhyasa or superimposition is sadrushya, is some kind of a similarity. So they always say that the snake is superimposed upon the rope because there is some similarity between snake and the rope. That rope also has some curls in that which the snake has, and rope has a certain length and whatever. So there are certain elements or aspects of the rope which have similar resemblance with the snake. Some resemblance must be there. Even we superimpose the silver upon the mother of pearl because there is a resemblance of glitter. That shell is shining and silver also shines, and therefore one may superimpose silver upon the shell. So it is our common experience that some kind of a sadrushya or similarity must be there between adhisthana and adhyaropa, between the locus and what is superimposed upon that. Some kind of a similarity or resemblance must be there. Otherwise, nobody will superimpose an elephant upon a snake, you know. Not possible. Unless snake is formed in a certain way, that one thing, that is an elephant. Otherwise, the snake cannot be mistaken as an elephant because there is no sadrushya. So they say that this condition of sadrushya or similarity is not satisfied here because Atma and Anatma are totally contradictory, like light and darkness. And therefore, how can you superimpose darkness upon light? It's not possible. So it is said, Nanu, Atmani Aropaha Na Upapadyate. Tasya Atmanaha Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Svabhavasya. Atma is Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Svabhavaha. Ever free, ever pure, ever enlightened, ever, you know, mukta. So, Svabhavasya Dvaita Vilakshanatvat. Atma such as this is totally vilakshana, means totally distinct, different, or even opposed to Dvaita. Asati sadrushye adhyasa asiddhehe. When sadrushya or similarity or resemblance is not there, adhyasa cannot take place because our experience is adhyasa or superimposition takes place only when some similarity, some ground must be there for the superimposition to take place. There is no ground here.
Ataha aha ataha iti.
Then Vashyakara said, ataha means asmat, samsarat vilakshana. Ataha is the fifth case here. As footnote number 6 says there, ukta samsara, ataha vilakshana, anam rupa karmatmaka, advaya, nitya shuddha muddha mukta swahavapi. Even though atma is ataha vilakshana, totally different. In what way it is totally different? Anam rupa karmatmaka. Samsara is name, form and action. Atma is no name, no form and no action at all. Totally devoid of name, form and activity. Advayaha, samsara is all multifarious. Atma is non-dual. Nitya shuddha buddha mukta svabhavi. Samsara is anitya, atma is nitya. Samsara is ashuddha, atma is shuddha. Samsara is jada, atma is buddha. Samsara is all bondage, atma is mukta. And thus atma is in every way opposed to samsara. Svahavopi. So samsara vailakshaname prakrit anamayati. So anamaruva karmatmakah advayah nitya shuddha buddha mukta svahavopi. Kriyakaraka phalabhedadi vaparyayana avhasate. Even though it cannot be explained, that is the case, Mahashyakara, that's all he says. Tathabi. Even though, so it is mithya eva bhavitum yuktam, this kind of adhyasa is not possible, cannot be there. Tathabi anyonyasmin anyonyatmakadam anyonyakramamsya anyonyadharmamsya adhyasya. Even then people do this, for whatever reason. Therefore we say that Brahman, sarabhutani, yantra, rudhani, maya, the fellows are all driven into moha or delusion, and that is what they wind up doing. Adipadena anyevi vishaya viparya bhedaha sangrihyante. 19. Devatiring manushyaha. So kriyakarga, phala, bheda, and then devatiring manushya, all of these different viparyas, which means all different things are totally opposed to the non-duality of atma. So atma appears as a samsara, which is totally contrary to it. Avabhasate. Says Anandagiri, arope praminomi karomi bhunje chaiti anubhum pramanayati. That's all. It's anubhava only. Ahamidam mamedamiti nisargikoyam lokavyavaharah. There is no explanation. Naisargika is uncreated. That means inexplicable. This inexplicable life, life is inexplicable. That's all. Right away it is said. Life is inexplicable. Let all the scientists spend all of their life to explain the life. No one can ever explain. That's what a scientist is for. To explain life. He thinks that by delving into matter he can explain life. And somebody thinks that by delving into cell he can explain life. But everyone wants to explain life. Vedanta said that life is inexplicable. So don't try to explain life. But try to understand the moolam. Urdhva moola adashaka. That moola is important rather than the vruksha. So pay attention to moolam. All the time Upanishads have drawn our attention to moola of the samsara. Otherwise you will get lost in this banyan tree. You start with this stem, go to another stem, and like this you will go on forever. What is at the root of the banyan tree? Let us look there. And so the Vedantin, they are also scientists. If you define a scientist as one who is in search of truth, then a scientist is a scientist, a Vedantin also is a scientist, and Vedantin is a Vedantin, scientist also is a Vedantin in that sense, because he is sincerely searching for the truth. Except that if you are searching for the truth of samsara, in the realm of samsara, you can never find it because inexplicable it is. Only anubhavam pramanayati. Anubhava alone is pramana for samsara. Praminomi. What is that? Footnote number 20. Pramashrayo bhavami. Praminomi. Pramata ahamiti yavata. This fellow says, aham pramata. I am a knower. Then karomi. I do. Bhunjami. I experience. So, buddhyanischitya indriyahi karoti. So, first of all, in buddhi, Praminomi, I know this. सेज ए फुट नॉट प्रमातृत्वानंतरम कर्तृत्वम ततः भोक्तृत्वम इति क्रमो दर्शितः. सो फर्स्ट इज ज्ञान देन कर्म एंड देन क्रिया. ज्ञानम कर्म च करणम च त्रिधैव व्हाट इज इट. ज्ञानम कर्म च कर्ता च सो गुणभेदतः. सो ज्ञानम कर्म एंड कर्ता दिस इज हाउ. So this consists of this samsara. That is all the prompting activities. So says here, therefore, praminomi, I know, then karomi, I do, bhunje, I experience. This is what happens. I know, hey, this is attractive, let me have it. Therefore I do, then I experience. Then again that experience creates another prama. Every karma phala is the nature of experience. So I perform an action and I attain a certain result. That result gives you what? A new experience. After all, what for are we performing actions? For experiences. Every experience is a bhoga. At the same time, it is knowledge also. And if that experience is pleasant, then there is again in me a sankalpa to repeat that experience or improve upon it. Or if the experience is unpleasant, then there is also a knowledge or a resolve in me to avoid it. So every experience also results into a knowledge, which knowledge creates another sankalpa to again have it or not have it, which results into again another action, which results into another result, results into another experience, results into another knowledge, and thus the whole cycle goes on of knowledge, karma. Knowledge is vyavaharika jnanam here. So the vyavaharika jnanam, karma and karma phala, the samsara goes on. And this is a proof, we have evidence that we have of the samsara. Avabhasate, it appears. Is not really there. Samsara is mithya, but it appears. How does it appear? As karta, as bhokta, as jnata. That's all. So jnata, karta, bhokta itself is samsara. And that is, atma appears as jnata, atma appears as karta, atma appears as bhokta. This is samsara. Therefore says Anandagiri, atmani adhyasaha सादृश्यादे भावेपि नभसी मलिनत्वादिवत् यतः अनुभूयते अतः सविलास अविद्या निवर्तक ब्रह्म विद्यार्थत्वेन उपनिषद् आरंभ संभवति इति उपसंहरति अतः इति. आत्मनि अध्यास सुपर इम्पोजिशन ऑन द आत्मा सादृश्य भावेपि इवन दो बिटवीन संसार एंड आत्मा देयर इज नो सादृश्य नो सिमिलैरिटी एट ऑल. But we show there is Brahma Sutra, Vashyakara there also showed, Nabasi Malinatvadivat Yata Anubhuyate. Balaha Talamalinadi Nabasi Adhyasyande. So Talamalinadi. So all these children also superimpose what? Tala. The space also has a surface. Malinatvam, that it is polluted. So how the space is also called thought to have a space and thought to have some color and stuff like that. How people who do not know the nature of space superimpose these things upon the space, and that talatvam, then malinatvam have no relation at all with space, which is totally, this is formless, upon the formless space a form is superimposed, space which is pure upon that impurity is superimposed. Thus we find that between the space and what is superimposed upon that, there is no sadrusha similarity also, and so also it is possible that upon atma something is superimposed, namely anatma, which has no similarity with it. In short, Vedantins have to say that sadrusha is not a necessary condition for adhyasa. Only necessary condition is avidya. That's all. That is a necessary condition. And so, avarana and vikshepa. The vikshepa is a product of avaranam. 21. Ataha, meaning sadrushyadehe adhyasa aprayojakatvat. Since sadrusha, etc., that is a condition that you present or you advance as a necessary criteria for accomplishment of adhyasa or superimposition, since we have shown by illustration that they are not necessary, absolutely necessary, therefore, savilasa avidya nivartaka brahma vidya. So, brahma vidya, which will be able to eliminate avidya along with its vilasa, means along with its products, अर्थ विद्या तत्वेन उपनिषद आरंभ संभवति. Therefore, it is only proper that the Upanishad must be studied. That Upanishad has a place. that there is avidya such as this, and which creates samsara and all the anarth or suffering, and therefore, in order to become free from this samsara, Brahma Vidya is the only answer. Therefore, that Upanishad is quite valid. That Upanishad is justified. There is justification that Upanishad is. Therefore, there is justification that Upanishad must be studied. Therefore, there is justification that there must be Bhashya in the Upanishad. Therefore, there is justification that the Bhashya must be studied. Therefore, there is justification that Tika must be studied. He doesn't say that, but that should be justified. It is justified. That is justified in the beginning, that this Tika is written only as an offering at the lotus feet of my teacher, etc. You know, and then just to bring out the meanings. In order that, so there is Nyaya Nirnaya this Tika is called. Because what are the Nyaya, whatever reasoning Vaishyakara has given, that also sometimes are misinterpreted by people and not properly understood. Therefore, it is necessary that Nirnaya or ascertained meaning must be brought out of all the reasoning Bhashyakara has presented here. That is the purpose of this Tika. So, Tika is justified because Bhashya requires a little dwelling upon. And Bhashya is required because Upanishad requires dwelling upon. And Upanishad requires because life requires dwelling upon. And life requires dwelling upon because there is suffering. That's all. Since suffering is there, therefore one has to understand that suffering. And therefore Upanishad is required. Therefore Bhashya is required. Therefore Tika is required. Therefore Tippana is required. And therefore class is required. Therefore writing notes is required. Therefore studying at home is required. Therefore Sanskrit is required. Everything is required therefore. Because there is anartha in life. If that anartha were not there, we would have been relieved of all these things. But we would not be around anyway. And you would not know what to do. So since we have to do something, nahi kaschit kshana api jat udishthati akarmakrut, since the person can never remain inactive even for a moment, and since there is no point in performing activity which will involve you further and further, it only makes sense that one should engage in activity which will release you from the activity. And therefore, all of this has a place. So, Bhashya says, Ataha. Bhashya says, Ataha Asmad Kriyakarga Phalabheda Swarupad Etavat idam iti sadhya sadhana rupa viraktasya kamadi dosha karma bija bhuta avidya nivrittaye rajvam iva sarva vijnana apanayaya Brahma Vidya Arabhyade. Ataha. Ataha means samsarasya adhyastatva sambhavat. Since samsara is adhyasta, that must be proven always. If samsara is real, then no knowledge can remove that samsara. So before we engage in the pursuit of knowledge, it is necessary to be very clear that knowledge itself is end here. In this case, because samsara is a product of ignorance. If the suffering in life were real, then no amount of upadesha can remove that suffering. No amount of upadesha that, don't worry, you're not hungry. Child says, mother, mom, I'm hungry. No, beta, you're not hungry. Hunger is all mithya. No amount of upadesha will be able to remove hunger or whatever, because whatever reality they have it. Similarly, if the suffering, meaning grief, even if it had vyavaharik reality, even then it could not have been removed by knowledge. You require in vyavahara to do something. Hunger has vyavaharik reality, therefore you must eat food to remove hunger. No amount of meditation will remove hunger. Some pranayama can, but then that's an action. But since samsara is purely a product of ignorance, therefore alone knowledge can remove it. And that is why knowledge is justified. That is why study also is justified. Otherwise, so it is always necessary to show that samsara is a product of ignorance. Avabhasate, it is an appearance, which is of the nature of bhranti, which bhranti is caused because of ignorance. And it is knowledge of adhisthanam that is required. So, ataha. And then also, since knowledge alone can remove samsara and not karma, therefore one should be free from any activity And one should be totally devoted to knowledge. When can one be totally devoted to knowledge? When one has no further priorities than this. Then no other priorities can be vain. Only when one has recognized the limitations of all other achievements. Samsara gives us lots of accomplishments. Ashta Siddhi, Navanidhi, all of these are within the realm. Samsara is a great thing. The creation is fabulous with tremendous potentialities. Tremendous potentialities of achievements and of experiences and enjoyments and whatever it is are all there in samsara. Nobody will deny that. But only when one recognizes that in spite of all those accomplishments and all possible achievements and enjoyments, all of those things are still within the realm of samsara alone, that in spite of attaining all the Ashta Siddhis and Navanidhis, that you are still, that is Hiranyagarbha, within the realm of samsara, if this is what one has recognized, then alone the mind will not go there. Otherwise mind will keep on running after those things. So what is it that becomes an obstacle to the pursuit of knowledge? Or what is it that becomes an obstacle to abidance of the knowledge? This kama. Prajahadi yada kama sarvan partha manogatam. Hey partha, when one becomes free from all the kama, that desire arises from some fascination. And that fascination arises because of not knowing the nature of that thing, which shows ignorance of that thing. It is only because of ignorance of these various achievements in samsara alone that there can be fascination. Because the true end in the life remains obscure because of the various end that the samsara presents. That's called maya. It presents such temptations before us that the true thing that we really seek to accomplish remains obscure. Tasmat parang vasyati nantaratman. Therefore a person always looks outwardly. Nantaratman doesn't look at himself for the solution of the problem. And therefore, it really requires a great maturity, which is what we call viveka, resulting into vairagya. So vairagya is maturity, which is a product of viveka, or discriminative or proper thinking. Therefore, ataha, since the samsara is of the nature of adhyasa, and therefore it can be eliminated only by knowledge, and since knowledge requires a mind that is free, which has no vested interest at all, the mind that is not interested in listening to a given thing, mind doesn't want to hear things in a certain way, mind that doesn't require that things should be justified at all, that's called open mind. If I want that the scriptures should justify this, that and so forth that I think should be there, or if I think the scripture should present the knowledge in a certain way, and whatever, any kind of a requirement I have, that means my mind is not open to that extent. Mind is totally fit, like a clean slate. That alone is called vairagya. Yadate moha kalilam buddhir vyatitarishyati tadagantasi nirvedam shrutavyasya shrutasya cha. There will be total nirveda, a total indifference to what is shrutavya and shruta. That is a total free mind. And a mind has agraha, that agraha itself is samsara. That I want things in a certain way itself is samsara. Because again that's a desire that I want things in a certain way. That means what? Samsara. I want something other than knowledge. So that vairagya is not paripakva. Therefore this, asmat kriya karaka phalameda swarupat. This samsara of the nature of kriya karaka phalameda. All this duality of the nature of kriya karaka phala. Etavat idam, this is it. Etavat idam, says footnote number 11. Idam jagat etavat anarthatvakam. This whole creation and all the potential that the creation has, etavat, this much alone. Nasta kritah kritena. Akritah kritena karmana nasti. Uncreated cannot be produced as a result of karma. So that is, and what is produced always is limited. Therefore it is anartha. And samsara is of the nature of anartha in as much as it is karya, and it is vikarya, or apya, samskarya, utpadya, one of these, and therefore it is limited, and therefore it is dukkhatmakam heyam. Yad viditam tadalpam dukkhatmakam heyam. And that's how heyatvam the samsara is there by properly understanding its nature. Etavadidamiti sadhya sadhana rupad viraktasya. And therefore the one who is virakta, one who is totally has a dispassion, sadhya sadhana rupad, So no sadhya and sadhana also. That knowledge does not become a sadhana for accomplishment of a sadhya, unless again. If this knowledge also is looked upon as sadhanam, then I always seek something to happen. The knowledge is devoid of the relationship of sadhya and sadhana. Karma is sadhanam, karma phala is sadhyam. That jnanam is not sadhanam in that sense, to create something new. So even that idea of sadhya sadhana, that something has to be accomplished for which this is the means, even that idea also mind has become free from. So Vasyakara keeps repeating sadhya sadhana rupa. But that cause and effect, something to happen, something to be created, that idea continues to remain in the mind. Sadhya sadhana rupat viraktasya. This is a fabulous mind, this is a very rare mind. Very rare. And therefore the knowledge is very rare. Because to have a mind which is just totally devoid of sadhya sadhana is impossible almost. Means it takes a long time to recognize the trends of our own mind as to how the mind entertains this idea of sadhya sadhana and whatever. And as we recognize them, we become released from that. That is all granthi. What is it? What the knowledge reveals is nothing but this granthi of the nature of sadhya, sadhana, etc. As we recognize them embedded in our mind, then the granthis get released. But that is all the vairagya. Even the shastra shravanam itself becomes the excellent means for vairagya. Inasmuch as raga is a product of avidya, and therefore this vidya is definitely, that's why shithili karoti. Therefore, the root sad, in sense of gati, avasadhanam and visharanam, shithilikaranam. All shithilikaranam happens, then it is totally destroyed. Before samsara can be totally destroyed, lot of shithilikaranam is required. You can't break it like this, a cord. To release, suppose 3, 4, 6 strands are there, it's difficult to break it. You remove those strands, one by one you can destroy it, break them, you understand? Similarly also, all shithilikaranam. Then they can be easily taken care of. Sadhya sadhana rupad viraktasya kamadi dosha bija bhuta avidya nivritte. For nivritti or removal of avidya, which is the bija bhuta, the nature of bija, of kamadi dosha. So kama etc. is a dosha, kamadi dosha karma. So what is footnote number 12? Tattat dosha prayukta nishiddhadi karma ityartha. So kamadi dosha prayukta karma, that's how you would understand. So various karma which are prompted by the dosha such as kama etc. Well, kamadi, so ignorance. Or kamadi means then what we call asmita. So that is how kama the cause of kama is ragadvesha, the cause of that is asmita or ahankara. So ahankara, ragadvesha, kama, which gives rise to various karma. All this bija bhuta avidya. So avidya is the seed of all this anartha. Tasyaha nivritte, for the removal of avidya such as this. So see, anagir etavadit anarthatmakatva uktihi. Etavadit, this is anartha, that the footnote explained. Tattva jnanat ajnana nivrittau drishtandamaha. How ignorance is removed by the knowledge of the truth. Rajvamiva sarpa vijnana apanayaya, just as the sarpa. So sarpa brahma is removed by the knowledge of rope. Similarly also the samsara, which is brahma, is removed by the knowledge of brahman, which is adhisthanam. Brahma vidya arabhyade. Brahma is adhisthanam, like the rajju is adhisthanam of sarpa. And how the knowledge of rajju alone eliminates the brahma or superimposition of sarpa, so also knowledge of brahma removes the brahma or superimposition of the samsara. And therefore the commencement of brahma vidya for removal of ignorance, which is the seed of all the anartha of the nature of samsara. Iti. This is how Vashyakara concludes what is famously known as Sambandha Bhashyam. So Bhashya up to this point is called Sambandha Bhashyam, upon which Sureshwaracharya has written more than some 1100 verses to explain this Bhashyam. Various things which are said, not said, and to explain them, Sureshwaracharya has made a great effort to bring out the various things and various issues that you can raise, which are all raised, and also they are dealt with there. So this is how the Sambandha Bhashya is concluded here. Om Purna
पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेदि मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ